sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until killing, killing, killing will be on the increase. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until you will see tornadoes will be on the increase. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until you will see the latter part of this ummah, they will curse the former part of this ummah. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not take place until children will be filled with rage. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until you will see people will compete in building tall lofty buildings. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not take place until you will see the women, they will have their hair like the humps of camels. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not take place until you will see days will pass quickly. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until you will see weeks will pass quickly. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not take place until years pass quickly. Isn't this the case today?
And the day of judgment will not take place until the fitna of Masih and the Dajjal.
It will bring with it the dissension of Isa alayhi salam. Thus there will be a great war and the world will come to an end. Child, she on that day won't remember that she had a child. Why? Because the sound of the horn. The sound of the horn is so terrifying that you will see mankind will be in a drunken state, but in reality they won't be drunk. The hadith of Abu Huraira comes to mind. He said the shaitan and his army will begin to run and they will begin to hide. They will begin to run and they will begin to hide. The Quran says on that day there is no refuge. He will look above the people. And what will they see? They will see the sky will look like the black filth of oil. It will crack piece by piece. The earth beneath them, it will crack piece by piece. The oceans will be on fire on that day. And they will explode from their places. Allahu Akbar, picture this in your mind. That the oceans, they will be on fire and they will explode from their places. The stars will lose their shine and they will come crashing down. And there will be darkness everywhere. And when there is darkness everywhere, nothing will remain. Every single thing in the universe will come to an end. The hadith of Abu Huraira says that the angel of death, it will say to Allah, O Allah, all those are in the heaven and all those are in the dunya, they have come to an end, except for those who you wish to remain alive, O Allah. Allah will say, who remains? And the angel will say, O Allah, Jibreel remains, Mikael remains, Israfil remains, and the angels who are carrying your throne, they remain. Allah the Almighty will say, let death come to Jibreel, let death come to Mikael, let death come to Israfil, and let death come to all those angels who are carrying my throne.
Then Allah will say, who remains? Ya Allah knows who remains. Allah will say to the angel of death, who remains? And the angel will say, oh Allah, I remain, you remain, no one else remains. Yet then Allah will say, I created you for a purpose. You have fulfilled your purpose. You also die and he will die. And then Allah the Almighty, he will roll up all the heavens in his hands. He will roll up all the worlds in his hands. And Allah will raise his voice. And Allah will say, I am the Almighty Allah. I am the Almighty Allah. For whom is the divine rule today? For whom is the power today? For whom is the kingdom today? I am the King of all kings. Where are your dictators? Where are your oppressors? No one will answer. Allah himself will answer. And Allah will say, power is for Allah. Might is for Allah. The one, the only, the irresistible.